Hi, I'm Yoshi, the green dinosaur. Okay, I am the one with the green Yoshis, but I was the first one that Mario found. When I hatched, Mario was the first thing I saw. I knew a lot of stuff because my parents talked to me while I was in my egg, but one day they stopped talking to me. Mario explained that Bowser, the evil Koopa King, was responsible. I wanted to know if I would help him save all the other Yoshi and Mario's... All the other Yoshi and Mario's princess, Peach. She had a tasty name. I nodded my head yes, then a stomach growled. Mario jumped on my back and said,
"There are a bunch of Goombas and Koopas and Peaches ahead, so you will get to eat your fill."
With that, we were off. We trekked through an area until there was a break in the enemies and came upon a man wearing green.
"Luigi!" Mario shouted at the green figure. "You shouldn't run ahead unless you are going to take out some enemies."
"Sorry, bro. I wanted to scout out the next area and found the castle, but it will take a while to get to. And you found a green Yoshi. That's great. Let's go on and free the rest."
Luigi was not one to be around the bush when he was on a mission. I was glad for that. After exchanging a few more details, Mario, now riding on my back, Luigi, and I started a long journey together. Not so much was to be said about the journey, though. We fought enemies, solved puzzles, and captured every castle outpost along the way to each stronghold. I never actually went into any of the castles. One known fact about Yoshi is that we were terribly afraid of the indoors. Not that it's for lack of trying. We can live in huts made from trees and leaves, but stone structures terrify us. That, and I personally am afraid of ghosts, so I didn't even step into the boo houses. At one point during our quest, Luigi found a cape and put it on me, and he ran, put it on for fun. He ran as fast as he could, and he shouted,
"Look at me, I am Superman!"
He jumped and soared into the sky. Mario and I looked up in awe.
"Who knew that the Luigi could fly?"
he stated. I shrugged. I had only known the guy for a few weeks, so they could have the ability to turn into cats for all I know. That would be weird. Luigi finally came down and said that he had found a magic cape, and it would really help with scouting out better routes to walk. Mario and I could only nod, more surprised that he was calm after being flung into the sky and prepared than the fact that he had just been flown. We kept going like this for a while. Luigi went ahead and scouted the area, much faster now that he could fly, while Mario and I took out all of Bowser's minions in the area. That was our pattern. We were used to it. Nothing went wrong.
Why is this being told like a war story?
We were used to it. Nothing went wrong that day. But one day Luigi brought back news of the area ahead, and it didn't sound fun. There was an abyss ahead. The bottom was hidden beneath a sheet of fog, and the only way to cross it was a path of giant red and green mushrooms. Luigi said that it would take out as many enemies as he could the next day so that Mario and I could focus just on jumping from mushroom to mushroom. With that in mind, we slept for the night.
I'm gonna go back to the other voice.
When Mario, who as always was riding on my back, not that I minded, and I arrived at the mushroom path, we wasted no time in getting across. Luigi kept true to his word, because there wasn't a single Koopa in sight for miles. Mario and I cruised along with ease until we came across one particular jump that made Mario stop me from continuing.
"Hey, Yoshi, do you think you can jump at this?"
He looked almost ashamed, avoiding eye contact.
"I know Luigi would be able to, but, I can't. Do you think we'll be able to get to the other side?"
He was embarrassed and had to ask me for help. I looked at him with fierce eyes, nodding my head. Any Yoshi could make that jump. Because Mario had ridden me all of my life, I was far stronger than any other Yoshi. It took a few seconds, but he finally returned my gaze, saying,
"Okay, then."
He jumped on my back. I backed up to the edge of the mushroom we were on, planning to get off a running start. I took off, sprinting at full speed, racing towards the edge. The edge came and went as I jumped into a high arc, up and up as we went, almost half to the other mushroom. Before I reached halfway point, we started going down. Then I realized that even though I was stronger because Mario rode on my back, he weighed me down. This jump was impossible with him on my back. We were going to die.
But then a second thought occurred to me. If one of us could live, I made my choice. A tear came into my eye. I didn't even get to say goodbye. I grabbed Mario's hand and threw him as hard as I could to the other mushroom, and in doing so, sealing my fate. The last thing I heard as I fell was Mario scream,
"Yoshi, no!"
After I'd... Oh, Luigi's point of view.
From here on out.
Oh, fuck.
After I finished clearing out the mushroom bridges I had come to call it, I was waiting for half an hour to rest from all the fighting. After resting, I decided to go on and see if Mario and Yoshi needed my help getting to the other side. Mario may have been older, but I still worried about him and Yoshi. As I got them to fly out to find them, I saw Mario jump in the last few gaps between the mushrooms, Alone, as he got closer, I saw that his eyes were dead and his cheeks puffy. I ran up to meet him. Mario, are you okay? I hesitated to ask, but I had to. Where is Yoshi, Mario?
Oh, God. That voice. It's fucking horrible, my sinuses.
After... When Mario reached the solid ground, he only walked, his hat hiding his eyes. His head hung low. He didn't answer me, but instead walked past me as if I hadn't spoken. Mario, what happened? Mario, please, what happened to Yoshi? I could feel the tears welling up in my eyes, knowing that he would only confirm what I suspected.
He misjudged the jump. He wanted to go for it, and I let him, but we missed the edge by several feet.
Tears were flowing from his eyes.
He's...
What is this story, dude?
He saw that we were not going to make it before I did, and then he threw me to the edge. I could only watch helplessly as he fell. He saved me. I was too weak, and he paid the price.
Mario fell to his hands and knees, unable to hold back anymore.
I failed him. Because I was too weak, he had to save me.
Mario was never the same after that.
He trained whenever he got the chance.
Building muscle, jumping further, and hitting harder than I knew what was possible. Well, he could never jump as well as I could. He was more than able to jump the mushroom gap and that had taken his companion.
I can hear you now. What?
This fucking story.
What story?
I was reading some Mario and Yoshi fan fiction.
Why?
Oh my god, that shit was so funny.
It became like a war story at some point. It was like, we went on for days, trekking through the Alps, and our backs were breaking. It's like, the fuck is going on?
People that write fan fiction need to be killed. Oh my God. I'm sorry.
We good?
Either learn how to fucking draw and make hentai, or fuck off.
Hentai's fucking sick, dude. Fucking anime, dude.
Yeah, I think I'm good now. Right. I could talk about Mario. Fuck that fucking anniversary. Anniversary fucking sucks.
I shall presently continue. Hello, welcome. I don't know why I'm starting this episode with an accent. Why? What did I do to deserve this? I'm a good person. I think I'm a pretty good person. I didn't deserve any of this.
You're kind of close.
Bro, look, I know I said... Look, I know I said...
I know I committed arson.
I know I said when I would eradicate all British people, that was a little out of pocket. But
I think many would agree with you, to be honest. Right?
Are there anybody who likes British people? Like, not the accent. Some people love the accent, which is fine. But are there any human beings who like the people from Britain?
I can't think of any.
If so, why?
All right. So, this year is the 35th anniversary of Mario. Now, what that means is that Nintendo's doing a bunch of Mario stuff, and they did this direct about Mario. Now, we'll save the collection for last, but I'm gonna go over what they talked about. Bro, can I just...
Holy shit. It always astonishes me when I can eat, like, something way bigger than Yoshi. No, fuck off.
Where is it?
Are you kidding me?
Why can't people just make articles that are just like, this is what happened?
I had that, complaint about during fucking, when I was looking for the PlayStation 5 event stuff. It was like, but why?
Yours was... They just had the name, no pictures whatsoever.
I have no context for what these games look like.
Literally, I'm telling you, like, it looks like a Pixar movie. It looks beautiful, and you're just looking at the name. Okay, so first off, they're making a Mario Bros. Battle Royale.
I'm not even gonna ask you.
What? You should have.
Oh fuck! It's a match pair game.
All right. Fourth one at top row.
I think these two are match. Yep. Okay.
Fourth one, top row.
All right.
Bottom row, left to the star that you just got. Left. Yes, sir. All right, that's all I know. All
right. Let's go fishing. Wait, I think it was this one? Yeah.
Oh, three pairs.
Fuck.
I wish I could have a pair.
Of?
Balls. God, why is my voice like this? Why have my balls not dropped?
Shit.
I remember middle school, these guys came up to me and started talking to me. Mm. And they heard my voice and like, well, I thought you would have sounded completely different. I'm like, man, I can't fucking change this shit, man. I can't go into a character creator and change my voice to Gruff Man Number One.
I've heard from most people that my voice sounds exactly like how they think I would sound.
Fuck you, then. I don't got that privilege.
Yeah, but
people think I sound like fucking Morgan Freeman or something. That's a fucking tough fucking hurdle to go over.
Oh, you fucking God.
Okay.
Son of a bitch, damn it. I can't even get the fucking baby. Mario. Jesus.
Oh my god, that was last second. So Nintendo had a direct, and first, I don't know what they showed off first, but I'm just going to do an order of least care to most care.
In your opinion.
Or like, okay. They're making, you know what, it's not even about care. I'm just saying, whatever. They're making a Game & Watch Super Mario Bros. Edition. That is just a Game & Watch with one game. Super Mario Bros.
All Game & Watches only had one game.
I know, but... Oh, wait, no, wait. It doesn't only have one game.
What does it have?
It comes with some Game & Watch Mario editions. Like the one where you catch the balls.
Oh,
they have one where it's just Mario face on it.
That sounds pretty... That sounds kind of cool as a collector's item.
Oh, there's also... it's a clock, too. A Mario-themed clock.
I had that for my DSi. A fucking Mario clock.
Oh, and it has Yoshis in the NES Mario style.
That's interesting.
Oh, and also Super Mario Bros. 2, Lost Levels. So
why would you want that game,
though? It's actually a lot of stuff on that. You know? How much is this?
If it's over $35, I wouldn't get it. But if it's like, if it's $35 or under $30, I'd get it. I was like, it seems neat.
I mean, it depends on, it's $50.
$50? That's a.
It's probably built well.
Oh, I mean, it's Nintendo, so it's like, of course it's gonna be built well, but it's like, that's a lot of money for stuff that's like, it's a lot of money for a thing you're just gonna put on your mantle. You know what I mean?
It's a lot of money for Mario and Mario Lost Levels.
I mean, if you're buying that, I'm assuming
it's just a collector's item.
Yeah, of course. Like, if you're buying that, I'm assuming you have a Switch, and Mario 1 is just free on that.
So yeah, just a cool collector's item, and it's probably super portable.
Am I inside someone right now?
Why is there bricks inside of this motherfucker?
Oh, no,
what the fuck is that?
No.
A cloud crab? I guess you just have to jump over him.
I'm not going to take any chances in this motherfucker.
So, after that, well, not after, but we got the Mario Kart Live Home Circuit.
Wait, did you talk about the Battle Royale game, or is that after?
I'll just talk about that after.
Okay.
The Mario Kart Live Home Circuit.
What is that?
Nintendo Switch. It's just... I believe it's a Mario toy. It's just a Mario Kart toy. I think there might be multiple toys. Yeah, there's a Luigi one too.
Oh, I'm getting that fucking Luigi one.
Basically, it has a camera on it and it's basically augmented reality where you, it comes with a bunch of racetrack pieces and you basically make the racetrack and play as Mario. And there's also other like AI that's augmented reality.
So it like creates, it creates a racetrack out of like obstacles in your room or something?
And like pieces that the game, pieces that the, it has. So like it tracks like, so like in this video they show this girl has like cups as like a border and it sees the borders or something, I believe.
No, no.
So basically you're just making,
fucking kidding me?
You're making your own track and it's like a toy as well. So this is, this is,
sounds neat.
I mean,
sounds like a cool thing for a kid.
It's all, it's obviously not made for us. No. It's, it's for kids. And as a kid, this, this shit would have been fucking sick.
Yeah, it would hit. Right.
Probably would be annoying to parents though.
Oh fuck yeah! Just a fucking,
just like, why you come home? Why are all the plastic cups on the floor? I just bought those yesterday.
Why is Grant?
What? Why are grandma? Why is grandma's urn on the floor?
No, but I need the racetrack.
The ash is like, the ash is like the border. Over. It's like Coke lines. Look, mommy, I'm playing Mario Kart.
Oh, God. That's it. That's it. That like. If I had like, if I had like a, like a significantly younger sibling or something, or if I had like, or if I had a kid, that seemed like a nice little present.
That'd be a fun day.
Yeah, it's just like,
how much is this though?
Can I, alright, can I take a guess?
Sure, go ahead. I don't even know what it is right now.
I'ma say $40.
Alright.
Am I the father?
So there is a Mario set.
Okay.
Comes with Mario. I'm guessing there's a Luigi set as well. Comes with Mario. A bunch of cardboard pieces that you could use to make the, you know, the track.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes with like a, that looks like like 2 feet. No, no, no. That's not, that's like half of an inch of USB.
No.
I think
no,
that's just micro USB. And all that together, plus I think the game in there.
Okay.
$100. Out of stock.
It's just, that's,
I mean, it is a toy and it is somewhat a game.
It's just a really hard but sell. It's like this, like, is not the situation with the Game & Watch thing. What do you, what is,
why is he looking at you like that?
Wait,
No. No.
Wait, what?
No.
What?
He's voring you. We're being vored.
Oh god, no, this is not what I want at all.
You're being vored. Get out. What the fuck is that?
That?
Like, why is he in there?
I don't know.
Hit the fucking, yeah. Make him puke.
Get me out of here.
Isn't this what they did in Monster House, the movie?
I didn't even fucking remember that movie until you just said that.
That movie's amazing.
That's the one where it's like,
the movie's super surreal. That's a, like, not surreal, but like,
correct me if I'm wrong, that's the one with the guy who goes like, get out of my lawn, or something like that.
Yeah, like an old man who gets mad whenever you touch the lawn, because the reveal is that his wife is the house.
Oh yeah, the monster house. I fucking remember that now. The fuck? What are the shit they made us watch as kids, dude? Oh no.
Let me see.
Come on.
The cars will be able to interact with each other. If the shell hits your car in the game, the physical toy will react accordingly.
So basically your car is gonna spaz the fuck out.
I don't like how
progressively redder his stomach is getting. This is like kind of upsetting.
Well,
just me or?
All right, we're back. I don't know what you said. What'd you say?
Oh no, I did it. I won.
What were you saying?
Oh God. Oh God, he shit me out.
Hello?
Can you hear me?
You can hear me now?
Yeah.
All right. What were you saying?
He just shit me out. can we take a quick episode pause?
Pause?
Yeah, I'm gonna go dial that down for a minute.
Okay. I'm here when you need me. Are you okay?
Fuck.
I know what it feels
Harry,
like.
I just killed them all. Harry.
I know.
I had to kill them, Harry.
No. I know what it feels like to lose. I know what it feels like to be bored, to feel so desperately that you're in something and that you need to get out, yet to fail nonetheless.
Okay, fuck. Alright, I defeated the beast. Did you say you would know the feeling of being bored? What? The fuck are you on?
Shut up. No. I didn't mean that.
Jamming through the trees? Larry, put in a really shitty MIDI version of Michael Jackson's Jam. Thank you.
Who's gonna get the Luigi version, though?
I would. Luigi's sick. Fuck Mario. Fuck you, monkey.
Also, I'm guessing, the camera's expensive too. Because it has to be like 720p at least to look good. But your cart reacting to it getting hit by a shell? What about other items though?
Oh no.
What about like the ink one?
Your car explodes if you get hit by lightning. Your toy gets dismantled.
Lightning actually strikes through your roof onto the car. The car survives though. It's built different. All right. Next up, we got Super Mario 35, which is a Mario version of Tetris 99, except for with 35 people.
Oh, that's what it is?
Yeah, you don't actually like.
I thought it was just Mario Fortnite. The Mario Fortnite game.
It is a battle royale, but you don't Fortnite actually.
I don't know why that made
Mario
me laugh.
Fortnite. When are they gonna add Mario to Fortnite and then give him really long legs? Why is Mario with long legs so weird?
That's awful to think about.
Like, why is Mario not allowed to be tall?
He is forever like
5'2". No, Mario, you are short forever.
He is forever like 5'2".
So basically,
hold on, you know, I'm sorry to interrupt
you're
you.
Playing.
You don't remember that fucking stupid game theory where he fucking thought Wario was 13 feet tall?
What?
He made it some.
Why would Wario?
He made some game theory that was like, but what is Wario's actual height? He's actually 13 feet tall. And it's like, huh?
You know what? Game theory. Well, they've fallen off hard. I think shit started to fall off hard when they started saying Sans from Undertale was Ness.
Oh my God. No.
their theories are just so stupid, and they will like go on about like some other bullshit about how like Wario's toe is actually super large, and like the actual height of his toe compared to his body, if we look at it in a way of proportions, means that Wario is actually 35 feet tall. It's like, what the fuck are you saying? Like, Wario is shorter than Luigi. And Waluigi. I don't know.
Fuck you, monkey.
They did have a lot of MatPat did have a lot of fun making theories about Five Nights at Freddy's.
Oh my God. I think he like ruined that game for me.
I still don't understand that series.
Like before,
there's a lot of aspects that ruined that for me.
Oh yeah, not just him, but like the fan base in general. I still want to play Five Nights at Freddy's in VR. That seemed like it's a fun experience.
Like, I gotta give props to the man making it, right? But like,
dude, okay,
the fans.
This is what I'm fucking talking about. How can you just have an enemy off screen and have them hit you? This is what I'm talking about. This is horrible game design.
That's what you get for playing on the Game Boy.
But you can't. No, it's exactly the same on the Super Nintendo, though.
If this was 16x9, you would have seen him.
Game Boy isn't even 4x3.
16x9 Game Boy game. All right, we'll get into the whole ratio shit later.
Game Boy's like basically 1x2.
Basically,
fuck
Mario Bros. 35. Okay. You're playing through
with my cop
all of Mario 1,
mm-hmm.
alongside 35 other people.
Ew.
And on how good you do, you can attack other people's. And like, okay, how good you do, you get enemies and then you can add them to other people's game to make it harder for them. And basically your job is to take out everyone else, right? Like a battle royale.
This just sounds like,
now,
what was it? The mini game they had on a new Super Mario Brothers DS. You know the one I'm talking about?
The one where you're like playing alongside someone else. Yeah. It's kind of like that, but that one was just like get to the end, right?
Mm-hmm.
But you could also like interact with each other, I'm pretty sure, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this one you don't, which sucks.
Oh my god.
And a lot of fans are kind of like, because I don't know if you've heard of the battle royale someone made on Mario, which was actually well made. Well, you know what happens to Nintendo fan games.
Yeah.
The motherfuckers get lost.
Oh, fuck me.
They took that down, and it was... People had fun playing that, and it was just actual Mario Bros. Like, going through the level, throwing shells at people or something.
Mm.
And it's just basically, like, actual, like, interacting with people.
Yeah.
I understand Tetris Battle Royale in a way, but the Mario one seems kind of just like, we don't really have any ideas. Let's just quickly
to make something.
Think of something. Tetris 99.
Oh, it's your level.
Was my level.
Harry the Hedgehog.
Tetris 99 had a lot of downloads. So this is going to be a free game for Nintendo Switch Online users.
Oh, cool.
However. The game will be deleted on March 31st.
Why?
Who the fuck knows why? They don't even know why. All right.
Can we just take a second to appreciate this background?
Yeah, it's actually pretty... It's beautiful.
This game is beautiful.
This game does have a lot of good backgrounds.
This
especially.
This game is just beautiful in general. Oh!